Welcome back. So completing the square, I guess this is one of the kind of final ones with respect to quadratics, but definitely one that some students struggle with. Hopefully, in this video, I'm going to try to show you what this completing the square is all about. I'll do it through examples as well. The ultimate goal is when you have quadratics, there are kind of two standard forms that people use, which is the standard form, and that is the ax squared plus bx plus c. So the relationship between y and x, we know that it looks like a parabola because we have done quite a lot of videos on that. Now, the other form is the vertex form, which is definitely way easier to be able to grasp what is happening with the parabolas, because the vertex form, well, gives you the vertex, and then your a, which is the leading a that you see right there, is kind of telling you, you know, how does things, the parabola actually open up? Does it open up upwards or does it go downwards? You know, is it stretched out or is it compressed? That form is actually pretty useful to be able to have. And in order to go from the standard form to the vertex form, you can actually do it without doing any kind of completing the square. You know, one of the forms in terms of transitions from the standard form is something that I have done in videos, and that is just finding the line of symmetry of a parabola and then finding the vertex. And then from there, you can actually write down the vertex form because you have the vertex and then you can pick off the A straight from the standard form. And so I'll put a link to that if you wanted to go back and refresh yourself on those lines of symmetry and then finding the vertex on its own from the standard form. So I'll put a link up on top there. Now, that particular method is a little bit painful because you have to do quite a bit of work to do that. So the other method is actually completing the square to go and put things into vertex form. Now, completing the square is the first thing that you have to actually know how to create perfect squares. And when you have your A and your B given, and for that, I've done kind of two videos when A is equal to 1. So I'll put up a link up on top there if you've forgotten it. And then, of course, the other one, which is the more kind of common form, is when A is not equal to 1, and I did a video just on that as well. Okay, so I'll put up a link up above. So the assumption here is that you kind of watch those two videos and you know how to create a perfect square if A and B are given. Now, once you have that, then you can go ahead and try to see what this completing the square and transforming a standard form into vertex form is all about. So how do we proceed? Well, so let me give you a little bit of a background and then I'm going to dive into examples, which hopefully will try to explain this to you. So the ultimate goal will be this. We have ax squared plus bx, and then we have this c. Now, this c, okay, so I'm going to push this c away. Okay, so I'm going to push it far away because I'm going to fill in something within here. So I'm going to try to fill in kind of two things that I will want to be able to do. And that will be kind of the method behind this completing the square. And so from here, so notice if you have ax squared plus bx, we know that if that is given, based on the videos, the links that I provided you, you know, you can create the perfect square. So we can find a C. Now, this is not the same C as here. The C was, we're just kind of leaving away. You'll see where that comes back. But we can find a C such that we have a perfect square. And one of the things that we would do is, you know, so we can factor out the A, and then we will have X squared plus B. Now, this is going to be over AX. And then this is going to be all in brackets here. And then it's still that C is going to be left behind there. And then the goal is going to be to try to complete the square here, so create a perfect square. That's how we're going to try to proceed with these particular examples. And then once we have a perfect square, well, if you have a perfect square, then you basically are going to be able to get, okay, so this, as you see there, the x minus h squared, you know, the a is in front, and then it's just a matter of finding your k. So those are kind of going to be the steps that we will do. And they're not super difficult, but you will have to do probably a few examples to be able to see that. So I have created four examples for you on showing you how this completing the square actually works. All right, so let's get to it. So I'm going to follow this exact procedure. So here is, for instance, my first example. I'm going to bring this example upwards. My goal is, so I'm going to copy this, I'm going to paste it within here, and my goal will be to try to transform this into the vertex form. That's going to be the goal. Now, in this case, so what I have is, okay, so the first thing that we will do is we're going to kind of move this C away so that we're not dealing with it. We'll come back to it. So our first step is really just to work with x squared plus 8x, okay, so like this. Now my a is equal to 1, which makes my life easier in this case. Okay, I'm going to put this thing in brackets, and then I'm going to leave some space for myself. And that space that you see, that empty space, that is going to be used for that completing the square. So I'll show you what I mean by that. That 3 still stays behind, so we haven't changed anything in here. And now, so within here, so because I have this and I have this, then what I will do is I'm going to create my perfect square. So how do I complete my perfect square? Well, I always take, since a is equal to 1, so I can take my 8, I will divide it by 2, which is going to give me 4, and then 4 is going to be squared, which is going to give me 16. So this is going to be plus 16 if I wanted to create a perfect square. But now notice, if I just add plus 16, then I would change that relationship, right? So adding just 16 would no longer, okay, keep this in this form. It wouldn't be just plus 3, because the 16 plus the 3 would have actually given you 19. So I've changed things. Well, I don't want to change my actual relationship. I want to keep it the same. And in order to keep it the same, so this is kind of the little trick that you use, and you might use it more and more as you get into math. So the trick is that if I'm going to add 16, I'm also going to subtract 16, because 16 minus 16, so these, well, that's just equal to 0, right? So I haven't changed anything. And now with this, okay, so what I have is, so from this perfect square, so from this right here, so what I have is this really just comes out because it's a perfect square. So this is going to be x, I'm going to put it in factored form, plus, because it's a plus there. And then, so this is going to be 4, okay, squared. And x plus 4 squared is nothing else but x squared plus 8x plus 16, because it's a perfect square, we created it. This negative 16, you know, you can leave, and it's going to go outside of that bracket now, and then you're going to have plus your 3. Well, these are just numbers, so I can add them. Well, in this case, it's going to be minus 16 plus 3, which is going to be minus 13. So what I have right there is that this entire thing now is equal to, that's going to be x plus 4 squared, and this is going to be minus 13. And notice what you've done is you've created the vertex form. So the vertex here would have been negative 4, negative 13. That's what you would have actually had. And that's the vertex, right? The a is just equal to 1 because that's what we had right here. And this is called completing the square to find your vertex form. So this little process of finding this and then moving this C outside, so moving this C outside, not to worry about it, is the little trick that you play. So it's not that difficult, but because you're seeing it for the first time, it's going to be very odd, right? So just to show you, I mean, these things are exactly the same. So I'm going to graph it, right? So the standard form, which is x squared plus 8x plus 3. And you'll notice, so here's your vertex right there. Notice it's negative 4, negative 13. And that's exactly what we had, right? So this was the exact same. And if I plot this in the vertex form, this was x, and then it was plus 4 squared, and then this was minus 13. And notice it just overlaps the standard form. So these are the exact same parabolas, except one is in standard form and one is in vertex form. So that's what you're actually just doing, and that's the trick that you play by completing the square, all right? And you can put it back into standard form, you know, so you can put it back into this form by simply expanding. You can expand that x plus 4 squared, and that would have given you x squared plus 8x plus 16. And then notice that minus 13, well, 16 minus 13 is just plus 3, which is exactly what you started with. So that is completing the square. Let's take a look at another example so that you see a few examples. And, you know, from there, I'm going to do some examples that are not going to be the nicest because I'll also use decimals and fractions because they don't normally do that in school for you, but I do like to put it and make it a little bit tougher so that you actually understand the concept. So here's the second example for you. I'm going to bring this one down. Let me copy this, and I'm going to bring it down right here. And again, so our goal is to be able to take this, which is in standard form, and then put it into vertex form. So the step, so the first step is, so as you have this, so I'm going to take this, and I'm going to just write down negative 2x squared plus 10x. Always this is going to get shifted. I'm going to just shift it away, so it's going to be plus 7, so that I don't worry about it. Now, the next step that you always will have is, now if you have an a, so in this case we have an a which is negative 2. In the first example, our a, so here our a was just 1, so there wasn't really anything to factor. But your second step, if your a is not equal to 1, you're going to have to factor this out because you want to have this a in front, right, in your vertex form. So don't forget that your vertex form is always a and then x, you know, minus h squared plus k. So we want to be able to have this a in front there. So I'm going to take this negative 2 out. So that's going to be there. This is going to leave the x squared there. The negative 2, which has been being factored out of the 10, is going to give you a negative 5x left behind. And then here, so I'm going to put brackets, all right, plus the 7, which is remaining there. So I haven't changed anything here. And I'm not factoring out the negative 2 out of that 7. Notice that 7 is outside of the bracket, so it just stays there. And now, so I want to be able to, here, complete the square. So how do I complete the square? Well, I always take my b here, so whatever this, well, it's my new b, okay, so b prime. So I take this, I divide it by 2, right, so which is 5 over 2, and then I square it. So this is going to be now plus, okay, so this is 5 over 2 squared. And again, because I don't want to change my relationship, I have to, if I'm going to be adding something, not to change it, I also have to subtract it. So this is going to be 5 over 2 squared in this case. All right, because these two things would just cancel and give me 0, and then I have exactly the standard form. Okay, returning it back to the previous line. So this process right here is called the completing the square, because we're completing the square, where we're trying to find basically a perfect square in terms of a quadratic. So from now, what I do is, so I do know that this right here, so this is my perfect square, so up to here, and that, okay, in terms of its factored form, so this is going to be, so I have x, now notice it's negative, so this is going to be minus, and then it's going to be 5 over 2 squared. That's my perfect square. Now this negative 2 is in front there, but now what do I do with this negative, you know, 5 over 2 squared? Well, that negative, so I'm going to keep it outside of the brackets now, but don't forget that if you move it out of the brackets, it still has to be multiplied by this negative 2, right? Because it was inside of the brackets originally. So it was inside of these brackets originally. So I have to be able to take that negative 2 and then multiply it. So what I have is that negative 2, all right? So that's coming from there. And it's being multiplied by 5 over 2. Now this one, it's negative. So notice, okay, so that's the negative right there, right? Or the subtraction. So that's what I have there. And then, of course, I still have the remaining 7 left behind. Now, these are just numbers, so I can simplify this entirely, all right? Well, the negative and negative will be positive. So this is just plus the 5 over 2 squared. So this is going to be 2. This is 25 over 4 plus 7. So it's a little bit of work right here, but that's okay. Now, the 2 actually goes into 4. So this is 25 over 2 plus the 7, all right? Now, I'll keep it in fraction form. 7 is the same thing as just 14 over 2 with the common denominator. So this is going to be 39 over 2. And that's your final form. So this is going to be negative 2. So I'm just copying it from the top. X minus 5 over 2 squared plus 39 over 2. All right. And notice I have it in vertex form. So I know this parabola is all going to open them downwards. So it's going to go down. The vertex itself looks like it's 5 over 2 and 39 over 2. So that is the actual vertex. I can read it off and I can check it. So if I take this, for instance, let's take the original one. So negative 2x squared plus 10x plus 7. Hope I remember. And notice the vertex is 2.5, which indeed is 5 over 2. And then, you know, 39 over 2 is actually 19.5. And notice it opens downwards because our a is negative 2. So we have found the vertex form of that second example that we had. And that is the process that you actually carry out. You know, so you just follow the particular steps, and then this is called just completing the square. Let's try the other two examples. All right, so let's take now this example, which might be a little bit more annoying because it has decimals, but I just want to show you that it works in exactly the same process and the steps are identical. So here's my relationship between y and x. So it's a quadratic in standard form. So again, so my first step in here. So I'm going to just leave these. Okay, so this is what I am interested in. So this right here, I want to try to create a perfect square for that. That negative 5.1 is going to be left behind. So I'm going to just push it all the way to the back. All right, so that's what I have there. So that means that I'm going to be working with 0.8 x squared minus 1.76x, and then I'm going to be trying to complete the square. All right, so step one, okay, so that is, let's get rid of this 0.8, so I'm going to factor this out. So 0.8, it's going to give me x squared minus, now I'm factoring out the 0.8 from the 1.76. And if you factor that out, it's the same thing as saying 1.76 divided by 0.8. And so for that, so that means because I'm factoring it out, so that means it's going to be this. Okay, now I can check what that is. Okay, I have it actually there. And then divided by 0.8. So that's 2.2. This is going to be 2.2x. All right, so that's that. Now, this is going to be all in brackets here, minus 5.1. So I want to be able to complete the square. Now, completing the square, okay, so let's take this. This is going to be 2.2. Now, 2.2 divided by 2 is 1.1. And so therefore, so what I will have is I'm going to have plus 1.1 squared. And then you also put minus 1.1 squared, not to change the actual relationship. This right here is going to go outside of the brackets. And then the rest is basically just a perfect square. So this is a perfect square. So I have 0.8. Now, the perfect square is x. Notice it's minus. So minus is going to be 1.1 squared. This right here, so this, let me change the color. So this goes outside of the bracket now, and it's being multiplied by 0.8. So I will have, now it's minus, so it's minus 0.8 multiplied by 1.1, all right, squared, minus 5.1. Bringing this all together, because these are just numbers, so let me do that. I'm going to swing it over to the other side here. I have, so zero, and this is actually, so let's clear that. So it's minus 0.8 times 1.1, and this is squared. And then this is minus 5.1. All right, so it's not a very nice number, but that's okay. At least it wasn't anything in terms of a repeater or something. And this is my now relationship in, okay, in the vertex form. So notice that's what you would have. And because we have these nice graphing tools, I mean, on a test, again, you may not be able to use them, but it's always worthwhile to try to see, okay, and let's take a look. So it looks like the vertex is 1.1 and negative 6.068. This parabola is going to be opening up upwards because the A is 0.8, so we can do that. And now let's try to see this standard form right here. So I'm going to graph this one for sure, I probably won't remember. So let's see that. So I'll be right back. All right, so there you have it. So I just put it up there. Notice the vertex is just staring at you there, and indeed it's 1.1. And then negative 6.068, which is what we got. And then the parabola looks and opens upwards. All right, so that's what happens there. So that's the third example. Let's try the last example, and this one is with fractions. So people don't always like these ones. They also don't like the decimal ones. Now, luckily in school, I think you most of the time just deal with integer coefficients. So, you know, you may not have to run into this, but I always like to bring it in because if you really want to be able to understand what you're doing, you know, if the numbers don't always work out, you're still confident in the process. So let's try this one, okay, and let's see what it is. Probably it's going to be something ugly, but that's all right. So again, so step one, so we want to get rid of this. I'm going to push this to the back so I don't have to worry about it. And then, so I'm going to be working with these, right? So I'm going to try to be completing the square for that. So let's take out that 1.2 because that's my a, which is going to give me x squared plus, it's going to be, I guess, 7 over 5 x. And then I have brackets all the way around. The next thing is, so I have to create the perfect square. So I'm going to take here, so 7.5 divided by 2. Well, 7.5 divided by 2 is 7 over 10. It's going to be plus. Going to be 7 over 10. We have to square that. And then we also have to subtract the same exact thing, not to change anything for us. So that's what we have there. All right. And now, okay, so let's go ahead. So I'm going to take this entire thing, create the perfect square. So this is just x. Notice it's plus. So it's going to be plus 7 over 10. I'll leave the fractions as they are. This is squared. We have the 1/2 in front. This entire thing, so it's going to be minus. Now let's not forget, because that's what I sometimes did in school. I would forget to actually bring that back in there. So we're going to have to go 1 over 2, and then 7 over 10 squared, plus or that 1/3 there. All right, so that's what we have from there. Now, simplifying, so the back, I mean, I guess this is the annoying part because the numbers aren't very nice. That's going to be minus now 1/2 7, so I guess this is 49 over 100. It's multiplying there. 1 over 3, still adding. This is really bad. So 49 over 200 plus 1/3. All right. And now you can, you know, find a common denominator. I mean, I guess I'll kind of cheat a little bit as it's in the video. So here what we have minus, I'll use the fraction buttons on my calculator here, over 200, and then plus, I guess this is 1/3. And then I can hit just equals. Let's change it back to fraction. I mean, I guess I should have known that this is 53 over 600. All right, so that's what we have. And actually, I guess it's zero. Just I'll write it here on the side for myself because I'll graph it in just a second and so on. So that's what we have there, which means that my entire, so vertex form is 1/2, x plus 7 over 10 squared, and this would have been, I guess, plus 53 over 600. So I'll leave it in that form. So my vertex is negative 7 over 10 and 53 over 600. Okay, so it's going to be a parabola opening up upwards. That's what we're going to see. So let's graph it and then see if we actually got the right thing. So this was 1/2 x squared plus 7 over 10x plus 1/3. Okay, so I'll be right back. All right, so there we have it. Here's our vertex. So notice negative 0.7 and 0.088, which is what we had, and it's opening up upwards, so negative 0.7. So I mean, we have it in fraction form, but that's what it is in decimal form. So there you have it. That's kind of how you create these and complete the perfect squares. You know, I do encourage you to try them. You know, so go back and now try these examples on your own to be able to see if you understand the process. And, you know, if you have any questions, you can put them down in the comments. I'll be happy to try to answer if I can. It's not a difficult concept once you grab the intuition behind it, but someone has to show you these tricks so that you can learn and then start applying them a little bit later on. Okay, so this is how you go from the standard form to the vertex form for quadratic relations. All right, see you in a future video. Bye, everybody. Cheers.